Hi, welcome to Code Conversations. Today we're talking to Jimmy Campbell.
So today I want to talk about the IIS administration API. And for this code conversation, I thought a good topic would be one of the most important resources of IIS, and that's the website.
Okay.
And so I want to talk about how we implemented the website resource in the IIS administration API, and that can kind of give an idea of what it means to implement any resource in our code base.
Awesome.
All right. So this is the API Explorer that I brought up in our last code conversation. This allows you to browse the API endpoints that the IIS administration API exposes.
So this is that REST API endpoint you described last time, and this allows you to go through and configure and set up and do all kinds of things with IIS.
Exactly. It allows you to configure IIS, monitor health, set up HTTPS endpoints on your websites, the works.
Great.
And this tool right here allows you to see exactly how the API is exposing itself. As you see right here, the web server endpoint has websites. We expect IIS to have some websites set up if we're serving any content. So I just want to show what a website resource looks like. And this is it right here. So if you're consuming this API, this is going to be the response you get whenever you're querying a website resource. So this tool is really good for maybe prototyping, like your first time using it. You can see exactly what you're working with here. You can see I have binding set up for HTTPS, HTTP binding, my name, and all these properties that I need to administer my websites. Mm-hmm. So now we can jump into the code and I can show you all how this is done. So this is the code base for the IIS administration API, and right now I'm in the websites plugin. So the first thing that happens for every plugin, well, every resource in IIS is first of all implemented as a plugin in this code base. Now, on the start of the application, these plugins are loaded, and we talked about it in our last code conversation. So an important thing to talk about in the websites plugin is what's happening when it starts up. So overall, it's pretty simple. You can see the websites plugin is just registering one controller, the sites controller, and it's listening to the websites path, or it's processing requests on the websites path.
Okay.
So that was what we said plugins were capable of doing, having their own controllers registered, and then they're on their own at that point. So we have the sites controller exposing the website resource. So let's go into that.
Okay, now, so this is a standard, this is a controller.
Yeah,
this is something I'm used to.
Exactly. So we have our plugins. They pretty much have one or two controllers, and they're in charge of serializing the resource and knowing how to manipulate the resource. So it's really isolated. That's
okay.
Kind of the architecture we went with. And we make sure that whenever it comes to manipulating a resource, we do it in a REST manner, and we isolate all manipulation of that resource to one controller. So it's one entry point into the code.
Okay.
And we want to be able to support things like create, read, update, delete, and we do that in the REST way by having get for reading, post for creating, patch for updating. So we use patch and delete, of course, the deleting. Mm-hmm. So as you can see, this is where any operation with a website in the IIS administration API is going to take place. So for example, we can talk about what's happening whenever we retrieve the websites through the IIS administration API. So we come into our sites controller that's registered by the plugin. The first thing we're doing is we're checking for any filtering. Are you looking at all the sites for an application pool? That's something we support. Or are you just trying to get all the sites? So we take that into account. We get all the sites together. Then we just set some additive information to the response, such as how many items are in the response. So we're setting some headers. And then we support the ability to select the fields that the resource shows in the response.
Oh, okay.
So actually, let me show that right here. If I say fields equals name, it only returns the name.
Yeah.
And if I do fields equals star, it'll return everything. So that's what's happening right here.
Okay.
And then finally, we return the websites.
Okay.
So ultimately, we keep our controllers pretty nice and clean.
Mm-hmm.
So we want to be able to isolate exactly where the code is entering, and we don't want to overcomplicate it right at the start. So Every plugin has the controller, and then one other thing I want to touch on is exactly the model we use for taking this C-sharp class, this resource that we use in code, and making it something that adheres to a JSON response. It's something a JSON object would look like.
Okay.
So you'll see all of our plugins use this toJSON model, and whenever we return something, every resource will have a helper method like this. And what we do here is, if I go to, actually, I'll just go straight to it. toJSON model. All right, so we have a site resource in, or a site object in our code, mm-hmm. and we want to turn that into something, an anonymous object is what we use that we can transfer over the wire, and it's useful when you're consuming a REST API.
Okay.
So in all of our plugins, we have the same model. We always serialize something to JSON model. That's what we're going to put on the wire.
Mm-hmm.
And so we take some resource, the fields that we want to expose, we add to those fields, and we use notation. This snake case, I believe,
okay.
is the case here. So we're basically saying like a site's physical path is now going to be this thing right here. And that's
okay.
the model that we use. So this controller entry point and then the toJSON model exit point is the basis of all of our plugins. So they're starting up, exposing some endpoints, goes in the controller. Whatever processing it does, ultimately it comes into some JSON model and then it exits.
Okay.
MVC is going to serialize that for us using the JSON library that it uses. But that's the architecture that we're using. So
cool. Okay.
Yeah, so that's pretty much all I wanted to touch on, basically these standard things that all of our plugins are doing for today.
Mm-hmm.
And one last thing I want to bring up is just a reminder that this is open source. So you can go to GitHub. You can go to GitHub in our if it comes up right here, just wait for it to load.
Wait for it.
All right, yeah, so this IIS administration API is completely open source. The code is available here. So if you ever want to contribute or make some suggestions to the way we're developing things, feel free to go ahead and do that.
Awesome. OK, thanks a bunch, Jimmy.
Cool, thank you.